Hello everyone. Our topic for today is trigonometry. So the word trigonometric is a Greek word which is divided into two parts, that is trigono and metric. So trigono means triangle and metric means measure. So in this chapter we are going to measure a triangle, that is a right angle triangle. Before beginning with the formulas, the ratios and the relations, let me tell you one thing. This chapter has a relation through our real life. That is, there are some applications of trigonometry in our day-to-day life. Let's see what are those. When you see a tower, a building or a lighthouse, you wonder what is the height of this. Now to find the accurate length of that particular building or tower, you need to measure it. So you can measure it with the help of trigonometry. How? Now suppose this is the building, you are standing over here, that is you. You are measuring the height, that is this is the point of vision and you are watching over here. So you have to find this height and this becomes the ground, that is where you are standing. This forms a right angle triangle. Now there are few ratios, identities through which you can use it and you can find the sides, the height of the tower or building. Now in trigonometry, one of the angles is given theta. Now one of the angles means either this one or either this one is given as theta. This cannot be theta because this is always 90 degree. In a right angle triangle, the perpendicular one is always 90 degree. Either this will be given as theta or this will be given as theta. So now we will learn few trigonometric ratios, that is sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec and cot. First we will learn the three ratios and then we will learn the next four. That is, first is sin theta, then is cos theta and the last one is tan theta. So these are the three ratios which we are going to learn first. Sin theta is opposite upon hypotenuse. Here in this triangle, I have taken angle B as the theta. So the side opposite to the theta is the opposite side. So this is the opposite side here. The adjacent side is BC. And this becomes the hypotenuse. So sine theta is opposite upon hypotenuse. Here opposite side is AC. And hypotenuse is A. Cos theta. Cos theta is adjacent upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side is BC. Hypotenuse is A. That is equal to BC upon AB. Next is tan theta. Tan theta is opposite upon adjacent. So the opposite side is AC upon the adjacent side is BC. So these are the three ratios first we have learned. You might find it difficult to learn this, but it is very easy to learn. How to learn this? There is a very simple trick to learn this. Many of them have other tricks, but I will tell you one. That is, we will see the first letter of each word. So sine is S, opposite is O, hypotenuse is H. So it becomes S, O, H. Here C, A and H. So it becomes C, A, H. Your T O A, so it becomes T O A. Now how to remember this is saw ka to. Saw is sine opposite upon hypotenuse, ka is cos adjacent upon hypotenuse, and tan opposite upon adjacent. So this is the way how you can learn the first three trigonometric ratios. So now the next three, that is cosec, sec, cot. So cosec is hypotenuse upon opposite. sec theta is hypotenuse upon adjacent. And cot theta is adjacent upon opposite. So here the hypotenuse is AB, the opposite side is AC. So cosec is hypotenuse upon opposite, sec theta is hypotenuse upon adjacent, and cot theta is adjacent upon opposite. Now how to remember these three ratios? This is also very simple to remember. It's just the opposite of the first three ratios. I'll tell you how. Sin theta was opposite upon hypotenuse. Cosec theta is hypotenuse upon opposite. Sec theta is hypotenuse upon adjacent. Cos theta was adjacent upon hypotenuse. Cot theta is adjacent upon opposite, but tan theta was opposite upon adjacent. So it is very easy to remember these three. You can remember the first three by SOHCAHTOA and then reciprocate it, and this becomes cosec, sec and cot. So these six ratios are very important for you to learn. So this was the trick how you can learn it. So we all finished with the ratios, that is sin, cos, tan, cosec, sec and cot. On the basis of that, we will solve the first question of Let's Equal, that is on page number 124. The figure shows that this is angle A, B and C. This is 90 degree. Angle C is given the theta for us. So according to the angle which is given theta, AB becomes the opposite side, AC becomes the hypotenuse and BC becomes the adjacent side. So let's solve the first one, that is sin theta. So as we all know, sin theta is opposite upon hypotenuse. So the opposite side is AB and the hypotenuse is AC. The next one is cos theta. So we know that cos theta is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So the adjacent side is BC and the hypotenuse is AC. So it will be BC upon AC. Now the next one, that is tan theta. So tan theta is opposite upon adjacent. So the opposite side is AB and the adjacent side is BC. So it becomes AB upon BC. So this was the first question from Let's Recall. This was the third sub question. We solved all the three sub questions from the first one. Now let us learn the trigonometric identities. There are not only three identities, there are more which we have studied in the earlier standards, and we will know those identities when we do the Let's Recall question number 2. So here are the three ones, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. It is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. How you will remember this one is adding the first two with square theta. Like suppose the first one is sin, cos, tan and then whatever it comes. So the first is sin and the second is cos. You can remember it as sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Second is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. So how will you remember this? This is very simple. It will be 1 plus this tan will become Tendulkar, Sachin Tendulkar. We know him very well. So this becomes Tendulkar square theta is equal to, this is Sachin, S Sachin square theta. So this is how we can remember this one. That is 1 plus Tendulkar square theta is equal to Sachin square theta. Now let's come to the third one, that is 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Now if you remember, I just said it that sec we will consider as Sachin and tan we will consider as Tendulkar. So here if you see it is cot, that is co and t is there. So we will denote this t as Tendulkar. So cot Tendulkar square theta is equal to sec was Sachin, so it becomes co Sachin square theta. So this was the trick how you can remember the three trigonometric identities. There are more identities which we will solve in the Let's Recall question. So let's solve that. So now let's solve the third one, that is 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. So here we will take cot and cosec. So here cot, if you see, it is co and t, right? And here cosec is co and sec. So here we will consider T as Tendulkar and here sec as Sachin, because in the previous one we considered sec as Sachin. So it becomes 1 plus cotangular square theta is equal to cosec square. Cosec, no, it becomes cosecant square theta.